I am Santosh Gadankar. Today I am focusing on the dynamics of machine. In the dynamics of machine, I am considering the water governor. In the water governor, the first method, the method of resolving the forces. The water governor, this is nothing but a water governor. It is a modification of wet governor. It consisting of a central mass and the balls here connected to the links. This we call as a fly balls. Okay, as the shaft rotate, it's the central load going to move upward, which in turn this balls going to move outside, which in turn the radius of this one increases, the height decreases, this side decreases, the radius increases. As the weight moves towards the downward direction, what happened, H increases and R decreases. Now I am considering the force acting on the one side of the governor here. This is the diagram I have written here. This is, I am considering the axis here, axis. This is the distance from this part to this axis we call as R. And this is the H height. And this is the fly ball. And here the fly ball acts towards the centrifugal force outside, which acts here, which is written here. These are the tension or the link. At distance, at point C, there is a dead weight which acting to downward, that is W by 2. This is the fly ball weight which acting downward. Okay, this is a C, B and P, the naming. And this line makes beta and this makes alpha n. Now, where the mass, small mass refers to a mass of each balls, where small weight is nothing but W refers to weight of each ball. In terms of Newton we have to express, or mg, m is nothing but mass of the central load of the sleeve in terms of kg. What is w? W is nothing but weight of the central load, that is m into g. R is nothing but a distance from the axis of rotation of the ball center to the fly ball, axis of the fly ball, we call it as a distance r. H is the height of the governor, this is the height of the governor. N is the speed of the ball in rpm, where omega is nothing but angular velocity. Angular velocity, because of this one, angular velocity comes in picture, which is radian per second, where the centrifugal force is nothing but mr omega square. Where T1 is the tension or force in the arm, which is explained in Newton. T2, force in link N. Alpha is the angle of inclination of upper link with the vertical. Beta is nothing but the inclination of lower link with vertical. Now, we have to, by using the method of resolving forces, I'm going to derive the formula. I will derive it here. Consider the equilibrium of the force C. I am considering at C. At this point I am considering here. That means summation along the y axis. Along the y. Here this is x and this will be y. And this part I am considering as a sine and this one is for the cos. Now it is in y section. Y. Then it becomes what? If we have to write in terms of, in this way we can write it out, because I am considering at point C, therefore it can be written as 4, it will be in this way, this part, T2 is equal to T2 cos beta, one more force which act downward, minus omega by 2. Why it is taken minus? If I consider positive this side, positive this side, negative will be this side and negative will be this side. Because the force acting toward downward direction I have taken is minus W by 2. Now, further it can be written as what? T2 is equal to cos beta is equal to, because we are doing along the some resolution along the y 0 axis, that is y, W by 2, capital W by 2 here, capital W by 2. Where further it can be written as what? Mg divided by 2 cos beta. I will consider this as equation 1. One more time I will write it here. T2 is equal to mg divided by 2 cos beta. This is equation 1. Now, considering the equilibrium forces at B. Considering the equilibrium at B. Now, at B, there are three cases. First case is centrifugal force that is Fc, and second is tension in the link or arm T1 and link T2. And third, this weight. First Fc, next is tension, and this is weight. Weight of the ball m is equal to mg. Weight of the ball. Now first, summation of forces along x-axis. X and y I am considering here. Now along x-axis, this is x, it can be written as what? Minus Fc, because the arrow is minus here, this direction, minus Fc plus, now I am considering this is a sine here, sine. If this is sine, if you draw a line, if this is alpha, then this becomes also alpha here. Mathematically, if this is alpha, this becomes alpha. Now I have to resolve along y-axis. Therefore, I have to consider the sine term plus T1 sine alpha plus next this part. If this is beta, this is also beta here. You have to resolve in sine terms. Therefore, T2 plus T2, because it is horizontally, T2 sine beta. It is very important part. If this is beta, then this also beta. This is alpha, then this is alpha. We are resolving along x-axis. Therefore, first I have taken this part. Next, I am resolving in this direction. Therefore, it will be a positive sign. Further, it is written as T1 sine alpha is equal to Fc minus T2 sine beta. Next, T1 sine alpha is equal to Fc. T2 is nothing but what? This one. Mg divided by 2 cos beta into sine beta. Sine beta divided by cos beta is nothing but tan beta. Now this can be written as what? Further, it can be written as T1 sine alpha is equal to Fc minus mg divided by 2 tan beta. This is equation 2. Now, summation of forces along y direction. Now we are focusing on the y direction here. Y direction. We have considered the x. Now we have to consider the y. If it is y, I have to take cos here. Okay, I will consider the cos here. Next, for cos is equal to, first I will consider this minus, because one w is acting downward direction, this is vertically, minus w plus t1. Now I have to go for t1 cos alpha, because this is for cos and this is for sine. I have written here, this is for cos, vertically I have to consider the cos. Horizontally, I am considering sine. Now it is cos, T1 cos alpha minus. Now it is, why it is minus? Because this is a sign for minus. I have to take T2 cos beta. T2 cos beta. It acts here. T2 cos beta in this way. T2 cos beta. I have written here. Based on the diagram, I have written here. Okay, this part plays an important role for writing this one. Next, T1 cos alpha is equal to W small w plus T2 cos beta. T2 cos beta. Now, what is T2? T2 is already known. T1 cos alpha is equal to small w plus mg divided by 2 cos beta into cos beta. This and this cancels and this become T1 cos alpha is equal to small w plus mg divided by 2. Now what is small w? Small w is nothing but mg, small mg. Right here, T1 cos alpha small mg plus capital mg divided by 2. This is equation 3. Further I am dividing here. Dividing equation 2 divided by 3, we get T1 sine alpha is equal to Fc minus Mg divided by 2 tan beta divided by this T1 cos alpha is equal to small mg plus capital mg divided by 2. This t and this cancels. This t and this t cancels. Further, it becomes tan alpha is equal to Fc minus mg divided by 2 tan beta divided by mg minus plus capital mg divided by 2. Transfer here, it becomes mg plus mg divided by 2 tan alpha is equal to fc minus mg divided by 2 tan beta. Tan beta. Bring the tan this side. Mg plus capital Mg divided by 2 is equal to Fc divided by tan alpha minus Mg divided by 2 tan beta divided by tan alpha. Tan alpha. Further, derivation is tan beta, let tan beta divided by tan alpha is equal to k. I am considering a k. And from figure, tan alpha is equal to r by h. From the figure, this is a figure. What is tan alpha? Opposite by adjacent. This is opposite. This is adjacent. Then it becomes what? Opposite by adjacent. Tan alpha is nothing but r by h. R by h. After finding r by h, and further, fc is nothing but what? We know that fc is equal to m r omega square. Mg plus mg divided by 2 is equal to mr omega square. This is omega square divided by r divided by h minus mg divided by 2 into k. these are cancelled and H will be goes upward. It can be written as what? Mg plus Mg divided by 2 is equal to M H omega square, this H will goes upward, minus Mg divided by 2 K. Further, it can be written as what? M H omega square is equal to Mg plus Mg divided by 2 plus Mg divided by 2 K. M H omega square is equal to Mg plus, take capital Mg by 2 common, it become 1 plus K. Now H is nothing but what? Mg plus Mg divided by 2, 1 plus K divided by M, divided by M omega square. Further, H is equal to M plus M by 2, 1 plus K divided by M into G by omega square. Equation 4 is equation 4. Or it can be written as omega square is equal to M plus M by 2, 1 plus K divided by M into G by H, where omega is nothing but what? Omega is nothing but 2 pi n divided by 60. 2 pi n divided by 60. Further, in place of omega, you can write 2 pi n divided by 60. 2 pi n divided by 60 whole square is nothing but m plus m divided by m, sorry, 2, 1 plus k divided by m into g by h. Now, n square, just n square is equal to m, small m plus capital M divided by 2, 1 plus k divided by m into g by h. This entire thing will be written in this way. 60 divided by 2 pi whole square. This side it comes here. Now, further, it can be written as what? N square is equal to small m plus m by 2, 1 plus k divided by m into g by h, g divided by h into 91.2, where 60.2 pi whole square is nothing but 91.2. This is the important formula which is required. Either you can use this one or this one. I will consider this equation 5. When the length of the arm is equal to the length of the link, then the point P and C will lie on the same vertical line. When this link, the length are same, if they are not given any distance here, then alpha is equal to beta. The explanation is very simple. They are saying it, instead of fixing here, if the link is directly connected to here, then what happened? Alpha is equal to beta. The P and C lies in the same vertical plane. Then what happened? In that case, tan alpha is equal to tan beta, or you can write K is equal to tan alpha tan beta is equal to 1. Substituting the values in equation 5. If you substitute in equation 5, then what happens here? Then it becomes n square is equal to m plus capital M divided by 2, 1 plus 1 divided by small m into g divided by h into 91.2. These two can cancel. The formula will be for this one is n square is equal to small m plus m divided by m into g divided by h into 91.2. This is equation 6. Equation 6. Further, run the sleeve. When the sleeve moves up and down along the spindle, the frictional force F act. Frictional force F act on it in a direction opposite to the direction of sleeve motion. Then the equation 4 and equation 5. Are modified as follows. Therefore, it can be written as n square is equal to mg plus capital mg plus or minus f divided by 2, 1 plus k divided by m into 91.2 divided by h. When we have to use this one? When beta is not equal to alpha, that is when k is not equal to 1, we have to use this formula. Next formula, when k is equal to 1, then what in place of k you have to substitute 1 here. Then it becomes n square mg plus mg plus or minus 5 divided by 2, 1 plus 1 divided by m into 91.2 divided by h. This and this cancels. Then the answer will be n square is equal to mg plus or minus f divided by m into 91.2 divided by h. Now, the positive sign is used when the sleeve moves up. Positive sign is used when sleeve moves up. And negative sign is used when sleeve move down. This is the derivation. Now, what is here? Sleeve this portion, when it is moves upward, we have to take positive sign. Positive sign. That means the speed increases here. Speed increases. When the slew moves upward, the speed increases. When the slew moves downward, we are taking negative, where the speed decreases. This is the derivation for the Potter governor. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.